Hello everyone. Dr. Babita Parashar, Head Department of Education, Manav Rachna University, Faridabad, welcomes you to this session on planning and curriculum coverage in science. So let us first begin with that what are the goals of science education? So the goals of science education at any level can be broadly categorized as development of skill of inquiry, nurturance of a positive attitude, and acquisition of scientific knowledge about the biological and physical aspects of the world. So to begin with, when we start teaching science, these are the goals of education of science in specifically in terms of science, what we begin with. Curriculum, as we said that we will be talking about the planning in curriculum. So let us first understand that what curriculum is. So curriculum is the connective link between the teacher and the students so as to achieve the goals of education, what we just discussed. There is always an understanding that curriculum and syllabus are synonymous to each other and has been very frequently used interchangeably. But since we will be focusing on the planning of curriculum, so let us understand that how syllabus and curriculum are different from each other. So syllabus is the document that consists of topics or portions covered in a particular subject. So you're given a syllabus by the state board, by the CBSC, that this is the syllabus for grade 6 science that is to be covered. But when we talk about curriculum, it is the overall learning experience that a student goes through during the particular course of study. So the curriculum is there for the upper primary stage. To again, that curriculum is a course of study offered by a school as a complete package. So there is a syllabus, there is a process through which that syllabus will be transacted, and there is a product which is in forms of achievement of the goals of science education, what we started off with. Science curriculum basically focuses on the development of the following attitudes or competences: the curiosity or inquisitiveness, objectivity, humility, ability to accept failure, and skepticism. We will be dealing each of these qualities in detail in the following session. But here I'll just mention that there is one situation in which whatever is being transacted to a student or any individual, any citizen, they accept it as such without challenging the notion. And at the same time, the objective of science education is that there is an inquisitiveness is aroused, and they wish to objectively question their observations, look for an answer, and explain their observations in terms of that. So these are the basically focus areas of science education. Advantages of planning. Why do we need to plan? A curriculum or a syllabus is coming to us from the state government or the regulatory body. So what is the requirement of planning at me at a teacher level? Why can't I just start transacting from stage one? So let us discuss that what is the need of planning in case of science or any curriculum for that. So it is access to a comprehensive range of scientific concepts. If I am sitting at the onset of the academic year with the curriculum that is to be transacted, I'll brainstorm in terms of the activities, visits, collaborative activities, group discussions, projects, which I can take for the better transaction and learning of the curriculum to be imparted. If I randomly go without planning, the effort and time will be wasted without resulting in the effective learning. Opportunities to work scientifically. If I have planned, I will beforehand be ready with a list of activities which can be planned along with the curriculum transaction further to ensure learning. A balance between the different aspects of the curriculum. I would just mention here that we do not transact a curriculum in the acid-tight compartments. We are in an era which is the age of interdisciplinary curriculum, integrated learning. So if I have beforehand started planning, I would be able to probably collaborate with the maths teacher when I'm talking about the components of food. So in terms of components of food, I'll be teaching in a science class to my student that in what portion they would be taking. At the same time, in the maths class also, they'll be learning about the fractions. And the curriculum can be integrated to result in an effective learning to the class. Integration of science and technology, if in the planning stage setting with the resources which are available to me in the form of technology, I would be able to take assistance from that technology for the effective learning in the classroom. In the application of investigative skills, there is a particular time season where a lot of dragonflies are there, where a lot of insects are there, birds are there. If I have planned my curriculum according to those seasonal or migration changes, my students would be able to apply the knowledge which I am transiting in the classroom in their immediate environment. So I will be able to foster their investigative skills by a thorough planning at the onset stage. Along with that, their inquiry-based activities can be taken up, activities to explore and investigate the environment, and also provide them for the continuity and progression in the development of scientific ideas. Now, what are the various levels of planning which me as a teacher need to do? So there we begin with the outermost circle, which is the year plan. When I receive the syllabus, I sit with and work out that how many working days are there with me. On each working day, how many periods or slots I'll be getting for science. Based on that, I'll be able to plan that what all activities will be conducted, because we have usually come across as teachers about the complaint that we are always running short of time, syllabus is so much, I'm not able to complete the activities. The moment I start with teaching in the class, my periods gets over. So all these kind of situations or remarks you come across when the year planning has not been done in a meticulous way. The second stage is the unit plan. The entire syllabus is being divided into several units, and these units are further divided into subunits or the lesson plan. So broadly, this figure talks about that at how many levels we need to plan the curriculum for the effective transaction in a classroom. To begin with, now year plan is made up of the number of units to be covered in science. As we say that we are in an era of integrative technology and interdisciplinary science, so we at this stage as an innovative teacher, as a proactive planner, I may probably take this opportunity while doing my year plan to sit with my contemporary subject teachers and try to map the syllabus. So when I'm talking about the seasons, I can also sit with the language teacher that at what time they are talking about the poems based on the various seasons. So whatever the child is learning in the science class, they will also be seeing its expression in the language class. So that is how we can come up with an interdisciplinary approach in the year plan. We start with that the entire syllabus is to be divided into units to be covered. This division is based on the number of periods or slots available for each unit in the whole year, because we have the evaluation to be going on side by side. There are vacations also coming. There is a festival breaks which is there. There are annual school events. So we need to keep all that in mind, how many working days, and then we need to plan. The holidays and vacations to be considered while allotting time for each unit, as I was discussing. And the content analysis and plan would include time for teaching learning, revising, and testing. So the plan is not just about the transaction. It should always have that scope that I need to revise these concepts before my students are going to sit for their exams, and the testing time which I might require in my own setup. The next stage of it is the unit plan. After that entire annual plan has been done, we sit with one unit which is to be covered in the pre-summer vacation break. So it is an outline of the program of action, that how it will be delivered actually. Unit is divided into subunits or lessons, which can be theme-based approach or interdisciplinary approach, as I just shared. It consists of intended learning outcomes, the teaching learning strategies and activities which me as a teacher will be adopting in the class for the effective transaction of that content, and assessment tools for the learning outcomes. So when I talk about one unit, all this is to be taken into account, and then that planning is to be done. And now the lesson plan. The lesson plan is a very, very specific distribution of the content. A lesson plan for a particular period It may be 30 or 40 minutes depending upon your school system. It is a very detailed and specific plan consisting of intended learning outcomes, description of teaching learning strategies and activities to be performed in the classroom, and tool for assessment of the learning outcomes. So here I'll just mention that we did one year plan where entire curriculum is being divided. In year plan, we divided the syllabus into units. Each unit is divided into subunits, and each subunit has separate lessons. So these are the various hierarchies in which the planning of the curriculum is being done. So if we take a specific example of a unit, let us say our surroundings, the lessons which will be included in our surrounding unit is environment, which can further be divided into biotic and the abiotic components. Biotic components, plants, animals, microorganisms. So similar activities can be taken up. While planning the teaching learning activities, the students might be taken on a visit to the nearby garden where they can list down or tabulate what are the various types of plants available, how many plants are the food plants, the fiber plants, the medicinal plants, and then activities can be planned accordingly. The same way, microorganisms, friends and foes, the teacher can take their class on a visit to a nearby bakery where they can see that how microorganisms are our friends and they're helping us giving those bakery products. At the same way, in our intestine, we have those healthy microbes which helps us in the digestion of the food. So this is how a particular unit is divided into lesson, and for each lesson, the activities are being planned by the teacher. Along with the teaching strategies, the assessment tools for each lesson is specific based on the intended outcomes which would be started the transaction of the curriculum. Now the lesson plan, we say we are done with the year plan where we divide into units. We are done with the unit plan. In the unit plan, there are various lessons. So now when we come down to the individual lesson plans, what are the various components which need to be included in that lesson plan? To begin with, we need to know that whom do we want to teach. So as I say that we cater to a class which is in terms of multiple intelligence. So the lesson plan or the activities which we are planning, we have to be very clear that what are the understanding needs of my students. So a differentiated learning plan need to be prepared if my class is an inclusive classroom setup. When to teach? Once a lesson plan is being designed, I need to know that if I'm talking about that what all they have got there in their lunch boxes to talk about the components of food and a balanced diet and malnutrition and similar concerns, maybe a slot before the lunch break would be the right time. So the class would be allowed to open their lunch boxes and then they can see, learn, collaborate. So the time in which a lesson is to be transacted is also important. What to teach, selecting the content and concepts. If I wish to teach about the tropical diseases or the hygiene concerns in the rainy season, so maybe the time before the rainy season is the right time. So they are beforehand prepared that yes, we studied in our science class that wherever the water is being stored are the breeding grounds for mosquitoes or insects or the disease causing microbes. So teaching that content after rainy season would be like they have already encountered and faced, and then we are giving them the knowledge or the information. So the time, the content is also very, very important when we do the planning part of a content transaction. Why to teach? Deciding the learning outcomes. When we are talking about the malnutrition, we need to know that that there is a lot of population in India which comes across health hazards because of a deficient diet, because of lack of balanced diet or malnutrition. So we know that what content we are teaching, it is not only intended as a content or as a part of the syllabus. The objective is its application in the right setting, and then we bringing about that change in the society, which is the objective. How to teach, selecting methods and strategies. There are two ways, in fact, there are multiple ways to deliver a content. One way is which can be done in a theoretical way when a content is taught, and we assume that once I have taught, it has been learnt. The other way which the science teacher can do is by relating whatever is being planned or scheduled to the real life experiences. If I'm talking about the hygiene, you can show them the people how the after a flood or any calamity, how a outbreak of disease happens. So what happens if their surrounding is not clean? So what all they can come across to? If they're eating food which is not cooked in a hygienic way or stored in a hygienic way, so how their health would be challenged? So it is very, very important that when you plan a lesson as a teacher, you are very clear that what are the objectives to be met by transaction of that content or the curriculum. How to assess? Deciding the assessment procedures beforehand. If I took my students to a market visit and taught them about the seasonal fruits which are available, and then came back and then taught them that in this particular season you get more citrus fruits because in this season you come across the diseases which are more infection borne or communicable diseases. So I might show them different fruits and ask them that if this fruit is not a part of your diet, how will your health suffer? What are the diseases you come across? So we need to plan the assessment strategies or the assessment tools also at the time of planning a lesson plan, so that in whole or in a holistic approach, we are doing the planning part of it. So we'll just quickly recap that as the popular saying goes, that well begun is half done. So at the year plan stage, if we have done our planning meticulously, there is no stopping that the year plan would be transacted into a unit plan and the unit plan into a lesson plan. With all that, happy planning to all of you and happy learning. Thank you from our end.